I recently wrote an article titled Why Your Diversity Training Won't Work. Now, some may see that title and get a little uncomfortable and say, hey, we need trainings and we need them to work. As a consultant and an educator, I agree with you. We need trainings and we need them to work. We're seeing an increase in the demand of these types of training, although they are not new. They've been happening for a very long time. But organizations are becoming more savvy and more concerned about the ways in which they approach diversity and inclusion. They're providing more and more opportunities for their employees to increase their cultural competency and also becoming more effective in the ways in which they communicate to multicultural consumer bases. However, some organizations are missing the key thing that they need that supports their training. Strategy. Any training or learning event should be a tactic inside of a larger diversity and inclusion strategy, because most times when a training is treated like an activity, the learning experience is much less effective and that training is not seen as a deliberate part of the organizational culture. Now, you may think developing a strategic plan around diversity and inclusion or anything is a no-brainer, but many organizations are going about their trainings without strategic plans. For example, would you ever even roll out some type of training to introduce a new piece of technology inside your organization without creating a strategic plan to support it? Without a strategic plan to support your diversity and inclusion initiatives, your training is merely an exercise. Implementing a strategic plan ensures that diversity and inclusion is embedded across your organization, engaged within functions and departments, executed through communication with communities and consumers, and evaluated for its effectiveness against your business outcomes. Unfortunately, if trainings are treated like an exercise and not supported by a strategic plan, your employees can suffer from pressure to participate, resentment from false commitment, and likelihood of losing interest in even working for your organization. Training should not be a check-the-box exercise. I'd like to hear from you. What type of diversity and inclusion training has your organization created? What kinds have you participated in? Have you seen the diversity and inclusion plan for your organization, and have you seen it be implemented and embedded throughout your organizational culture? Give me your feedback.